And also wanted to ask that if Ahad Reza Mir is supposed going to interview Asif Reza Mir. So, kya question? Okay, just ask for one question that you want to ask your dad. One question.
This is now the best interview I've ever done.
Oh, yay! Yeah,
that's a good question.
Where are the props?
Okay, let him think.
I would ask him, what is your proudest moment?
Oh.
And then see if he has anything to do with me.
You are your brother, right?
So yeah, yeah.
That'll be a difficult one, tough one.
But I think what I would ask him, and actually I don't know this about him, is what drives my dad. My father is one of the hardest working people I've ever met. He's like a machine.
I feel that your father is the driving force. Your mom and dad, your family, right?
Yeah.
And you look up to him, right?
Yeah.
And you wish that you had that drive. You do have that drive. You don't recognize it.
Like I feel like, you know, people always ask me like, aap toh achha kaam karte hain, lekin aapke abba, aapke ye, I feel so happy when they say that, because it's like, you know, it's like you've got big shoes to fill, you know. How do you feel like you ever come to par with your dad? I'm like, no, I won't. Like, I know this.
You want to learn
but I can try.
Yeah.
At least I'll try.
So he's your driving force, and his driving force was his father. So it's the genetic running in the family.
But Baba, one, he loves this country and he loves this industry.
Do you love your country?
100%. I mean, I'll be honest.
Is that a diplomatic answer?
No, it's not. Because I thought about this last night. If I was an actor now, I wasn't doing films and TV, would I be here? And I actually thought, yes. Because I don't know what it is, I can't leave Pakistan.
You have the connect.
But I don't know where it's come from. I mean, I've spent so much time abroad now.
Yes.
I've seen almost the world, but I just feel like when I'm here, log apne, you know.
There is so much to do that you can improve.
And Pakistan has given so much to me. It's like I feel like I have to give it back now.
Yeah. Achha, before I go to Yakin Ka Safar, I'm going to touch back on Parvaz-e Junoon.
Ek
koi dialogue humne dekhi nahi hai, frankly. But koi ek dialogue that really you connect with it and you want to just say it, like
that really touched your heart and made you realize something, maybe.
It's a very cheesy line. It's very cheesy, but for some reason it connects to the little boy in me. And it's just simple. It's welcome to Pakistan.
Aww.
But when you watch the film, you'll be like, you won't be like, oh,
you'll be like,
yeah.
I think it's the first time I've seen Ahad like in this. Oh, in all your interviews,
film,
it was.
I was like, the first time watching the film, I was shaking because I was so happy. You know, because you work so hard on something and you don't know kya shakal bani.
Achha, lekin apne aap ko dekhte hue kabhi conscious feeling aayi hai ya apne aap ko sunte hue, are you comfortable watching yourself? Because
I think I have to be.
You have to.
I know you have to,
but
I think mujhe apna drama, apni film dekhna mujhe acha nahi lagta hai, but I feel like agar main
dekhunga
to improve nahi karunga, right? This is why I also have a big complaint to all like the other, not senior actors, but the actors after me or before me, like, you know, Fawad, for example, especially, because I love watching Fawad, but he's so rarely on the screen. So like I'm dying to see him perform, because that's how I learn.
Yeah.
You know, like watching people like, you know, Baba or, you know, our senior actors, that's something else. But seeing those people who are like at the peak of their career, who, you know, people love them and people want to see them. I'm part of that group. I want to see, you know, whether it's Fawad or whether it's Hamza, because those are the guys that, you know, that I kind of grew up watching.
Oh.
So, not that they're old, they're not old.
But you're young, you're very young.
Yeah. Yakin Ka Safar ke baare mein, because we, abhi, as of now, because Pravan has been dekhi, but Yakin Ka Safar is so connected to us that we love it.
Thank you.
And love it for both of you, actually, you and Sajjal. And so its key ending was too sudden.
We want more. It was
that. Romantic scenes ho jate or something. So what do you want to, you also feel that way?
I think,
or you think
I do
okay?
feel that way, but अब मैं मुझे खुशी होती है कि आप ये कह रही हैं, ये नहीं कह रही हैं कि यार बहुत लंबा उसको ड्रैग कर लिया, राइट?
इस वो नो
तीन चार एपिसोड्स होते थे, यू लाइक हाँ बट मेबी थोड़ा सा वी डिड नीड, आई थिंक वेयर इट फिनिश्ड वाज ऑन अ नाइस हाई नोट,
बिकॉज़
वी ऑल वर क्रेविंग फॉर मोर, एंड सो दैट्स, बट आई अंडरस्टैंड नाउ, आई थिंक आई वाज मेंशनिंग इट अर्लियर के यू नो ये 4-5 महीने के बाद जब मैंने फिर से किंग का सफर देखा sat down and watched it. There was this magic, this fantasy world that was created, and that's when I realized that oh, that's what people were after. And watching myself and watching Sajjal, because I know Sajjal very well now, and like I didn't see myself, which is weird, you know. So I think I understood why people connected so well.
You saw Dr. Asfal,
yeah,
but he's dead now, right?
I think that's the sad thing. The last day of set, I literally take out like a metaphorical knife.
You do that with every character?
Yeah, and I'm telling you, I like, it's very difficult. It's not, like, it's really sad. You play somebody for months, and then you yourself have to kill them. You made them, and now you have to kill them. It's like the saddest thing. And like, I sound happy about it, but I'm not. I hate doing it. I hate it.
Let's move away from the...
Okay, Yakin ke Safar mein, if you were casting, who would you choose as Dr.
Doctor Asfal,
and I
would never change it. I would never change it. I don't think I. Not because I'm like nobody else could do it, but I feel like that's something that you can't mess with now.
That's
just
Sajjal's,
like Hamsafar. I mean, you can't.
You can't.
Sajjal's answer was also that. Yeah.
Also
Okay, so I wanted to ask you. You, what would you cook as a romantic date?
Because you love cooking.
Yeah, you love cooking, right?
Such an easy question.
Oh, really? No, we're starting easy. We're just going to, get you.
I think something that keeps going so that the date keeps going. I think you start off with something simple like salad. I think...
With salad.
I think I would go for a rocket salad. With maybe a little bit of like, you know, small tomato, chote wale hote hain, cherry tomatoes, some balsamic, a little bit of olive oil, pepper, and if I'm being bold, then maybe a little bit of Parmesan cheese on top, simple. And the main course, I think, definitely a steak.
What if she's a vegetarian?
Then I'd figure out like a...
Then I'll say, okay, good,
like a nice,
she can't think of anything.
Like a nice, like, kind of... Not a tofu alternative, I think tofu is a little boring, but like a vegetable, like, you know, like those big shiitake mushrooms?
Mm-hmm.
Like,
yeah.
Cut that in half, grill it, you got a steak.
Okay.
And then maybe some mashed potatoes on the side.
And dessert?
Dessert has to be chocolate lava cake with vanilla ice cream.
What if not she doesn't like chocolate?
Doesn't like chocolate, then we'll go for
I'm
a nice.
I'm sure right now.
Nice
he
spice.
Just I'm kidding, I'm just pulling your leg.
No, this is good.
I am only pulling
but
your leg.
But this is giving me ideas because. अगर ऐसा कभी हुआ तो alternative should be ready.
So are you trying to say ऐसा कभी होगा मतलब right now are you saying that you're single?
I mean I hope.
Are you telling the people that you don't have a girlfriend?
I'm not saying anything.
Okay. That is smart. We should have the prop. Silence is golden.
Silence
right now.
And same खाने के menu के साथ on your first date like what would you wear? What would be your think about a first date like how would you want it to be?
Casual, formal, what?
You know, I think that...